everybody. Welcome to the almost last day of the 7 of 7 Performance and Live Art Festival, curated by Mommelox Helsinki, Finland, and presented to you at the venue of Club Solo Breda, Netherlands. Tonight we present to you Harrie Liveart, and the performance that you are about to see is an investigation. It is part of a research project Harrie has been working on since 2018. And the name of the project is... Collective Perversion. Collective Perversion. And Harrie wants us...
for reevaluation.
Harrie wants us to revalue it.
Welcome, everyone. Today we will perform a demonstration of mechanics behind the making of coffee aged live art, the world's rarest and most expensive coffee. Thank you.
They found out
that the thesis of the Palms event included intact coffee beans that had passed through the Palms digestive tract. They picked them, they washed them, they dried them, they roasted them. It is claimed that this rendered a smoother coffee than undigested beans. This coffee soon became popular. In the early 2000s, the Western consumer demand of this civet coffee has led the civet to become a caged mouth-to-anus production line. The civet coffee has become famous as the world's most expensive coffee. But we are very proud to announce that this title has now been claimed by Harrie Liveart. After the eating of 927 coffee beans, through which we have created an even more rare coffee. Our coffee, which there is only 80 grams of, is sold for the kilo price of 2,600 euros. We now welcome you to come here and have a taste of the same beans as a coffee H. Liveart is made from the same farmer. So please, feel welcome to enjoy the Café H. Liveart.
Thank you. If you're getting old, you're not the guy.
Table, drama, perché è pubblico.
Nee, tuurlijk.
Ja, Klaus, hè? Dan sla je dan even die auto over en ga je meteen recht toe, recht aan.
Nee, ik snap wat je bedoelt.
Yeah.
Of this for 560 euros.
Okay, 20 grams is it?
20 grams. Yeah. So 20 grams is about one cup of coffee.
Really?
Yes.
I have a little bit of coffee,
yes,
that is.
Yeah.
But it's about the artwork. It's not, I don't think I'm not
going to
make real coffee of it, right?
Maybe not. Now it's empty, of course, because we have it here back, but you can actually get green beans. So we haven't roasted the beans.
We haven't roasted them?
No, we haven't roasted the human coffee beans. But if you want, if you buy it, of course we can roast it.
Can we roast it?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, we also found out from this, what is it called? The color light.
Like the ashes of the shell, it's making them black. So they need to be somehow polished to get the shine. Because they get shiny if you take one and you
rub it.
It will get shiny. So I think they do something like that. With the
maybe they add a little of
We had to stop.
And it's a big deal.
It did.
But it's hard to say if it was because we anyway had some type of flu, or if it was that the body got so tired of, you know, having this large item passing through, but we could really feel it. Like,
but maybe it was the berry stuff.
Different kind of examines that you made.
I don't think so, because we actually took the first layer, the red layer, away, and we just ate the fruit flesh and swallowed the beans. So we didn't chew on the actual, the peel of it. So it was very bitter and hard, and that felt like unnecessary.
Yes, again.